Raging Mistress, we're back. Yeah. I brought my pencil. Give me something to write on.
Students, today our class is about the band Red Hot Chili Peppers with the song Scar Tissue from their album Californication from 1999. So, no long intros today. I'm a very good teacher. Ta-ra! That I'm gonna stop. You didn't expect, and I up is stop. Yes, this is what teachers do. Yes, they unpredictable. Okay, it was very predictable. In my opinion, this is like a golden members of Red Hot Chili Peppers. They had a rough road to that place. If you know that all members of Red Hot Chili Peppers from the beginning came to Los Angeles from different places. For them, it was very important to have that connected vibe to each other. And Flea with Anthony Kiedis don't have easy breezy vibe. You know, they like a fun assholes. I'm calling them that with such a very nice intention, but I myself think, and my husband think, that I'm a total asshole, like a dickhead. We call each other that because I'm always joking around and my jokes is very offensive and dirty. And I know by myself that it's hard to be a friend with asshole. Hard to handle asshole because if you're not gonna understand him, he's gonna cross the line and instead of make you laugh, he's gonna offend you. Whatever. The thing is that in that golden era, on the drums was Chad Smith and lead guitar John Frusciante. And John Frusciante is such a member. First, when he came to the band, it was a chemistry, but when they exploded and reached that big success, not just playing small venues, but big stages, he like quit because he didn't want that kind of fame. Then he like rejoined them after decent amount of time. And it was that era with the Californication, by the way. And then he quit again. Imagine. Funny thing that in 2019, just 3 years ago, he again rejoined. And actually, again, they have that members in the band as this very song today, nowadays. Interesting, right? Or not? Or not, of course, you complain, complainers. I will probably rename my channel for complainers. Complainers Club. Complain lovers.
A louse in a bathroom stall. A southern girl with a scarlet draw. A wave goodbye to Ma and Pa. Cause with the birds of shade. With the birds of shade. Spoken with a broken jaw. Step outside but not to brawl. And autumn sweet wind, call it fall. I'll make it to the moon if I have to crawl.
Okay, so Scar Tissue seems like the song about drug addiction, but also could be applied to, you know, life and its challenges. Also, there is a feel like Remember the Song Under the Bridge and many songs when Anthony Kiedis wrote about his drugs addiction and all this loneliness caused by it. He has a lot of unhealthy things in his childhood. So he lived with his mom after parents divorced. And when he was like around 13 years old, he moved full time with the dad, who was an actor in LA. Imagine, guys, the dad introduced his kid in such a young age to marijuana, then cocaine, and all these parties, and all this, you know, unhealthy relationship. He formed the band with a flea, and they were kids. Come on, 20s. And of course, while that energy, hormones playing, and all these drugs going on, they all were addicted in the different level, and it's big part of their life and it's big part of their catalog. So in the beginning of the track, he's saying the phrase about the scar tissue, so he wished that somebody would see it and want somebody help him. He wants somebody to like know about his personal struggles. And if the song would be a sponge, it would be filled with the loneliness. It has that feel that he experienced in that loneliness. He feels that no one is there for him to accept him and don't judge him for his past, you know. Solo. I like that they left empty space from the last word saying to the ending, so you can like feel that loneliness and like process the mood. He like admitting that his loneliness causing by self-harm, like all this addiction is not always out of seeking for a joy and get high. You know, when I have a stress myself, I'm actually eating a lot of like candies and I don't feel that joy. It's like just consuming it and have a self-harm. When I don't eat sugar, I feel so much better, because that high sugar, fast carbohydrates just consuming your energy, and you like boom for a little bit, and then like I want more, give me more of this chocolate, and this is, that's it, click, you addicted to it. But in that case, of course, it's easier to break that circle with the candies than with drugs. There was also that line, push me up against the wall, young Kentucky girl in a push-up bra. In the line, it looks like he fell in love with the girl, but she probably didn't have that sickness level. You know, Red Hot Chili Peppers is a huge band. Huge band. By all these numbers and charts and amount of platinum albums sold. But it's not the best singer. It's a very good musicians, but this very that unique vibe, the style. They can be that kind of rap metal, you know, they are free about it. This is what I genuinely like. I think that their songs speaks to many people because many people could relate to that. And the reason why, if you share your real personal story, means somebody else could find their story in yours. If you're speaking about something what you're not really experiencing, it's not gonna be that persuasive on the emotional level. From all of this, generally, when we listen to music and we're trying to like review, say what we feel and stuff, what it gives us, it all comes to only one point and like one decision in my head that I need to choose how to feel about it. Because for people who adore their art and personality, famous people, they are role models. It's their idols. The question is, if you supposed to take advice from the guy who overcome shit or don't need to make from him a role model because he had so much shit. Drug addict, it's not just harm for himself, it's also harm for his family, kids, friends, neighbors, society. And it's not that simple. And you know, it's like somebody supports them in the case, oh, poor him. Another one gonna say, well, harmful person for society or stuff like that. Think about it. We're passing by some homeless person who like sitting in his own shed. Hi, you know? And think about him as a like potential, you could be Anthony Kiedis. But I choose to think that Anthony Kiedis overcome shit. Even though that addiction was strong, he overcame it and he reached the level of success. And he never actually quit the band and he had that stubbornness in that. So many people even can like attend to rehearsal. This is my side. I choosing to say, wow, guy wasn't perfect. You had a rough past. And maybe you're not like the best husband material, but as a musician, you are a role model. I hope you had some nice 10 minutes with me and see you maybe next time. Thank you for joining. Bye-bye.